So, someone has deliberately cut the fence. As you can see, someone has deliberately cut the fence. Do I know why? I can take a gander, because the only thing that would make sense isn't a break-in, because, well, I don't lock the gates. So, it's deliberately cut, and there can only be a secondary reason why it was deliberately cut. And that being, someone wanted to let the dogs out. And there's only one person I can think of that would want that, so they can get me in theoretical trouble. Funnily enough, the actual hilarious bit is that it would be a stupid scenario. So, somebody deliberately cut the fence. Do I know why? I can only take a guess, but in reality, I do not know or understand the reasoning. But, yeah. And I can take a gander at who might have done it and their reasoning. Their reasoning would be because, well, dogs, like, you know, I have dogs that gets out of the yard every now and then through holes in the backyard, and I have a neighbor, or, you know, the person that owns the trailer park next door was chased by said dogs, you know, and so on and so forth. Put it simply, the trailer park folks don't like my dogs. So, and the owner damn sure doesn't like my dogs. So, in other words, yeah. Reason being could be because they want to get me in trouble, or, you know, have the dogs basically run loose. But of course, you know, they can't get me in trouble. And, you know, if they don't like my dogs, then why make it harder for me to keep the dogs in the fence? Yeah. And of course, the only way for me to get in trouble is if I lived in city limits. I do not. So, technically speaking, that means that depending on which parish you live in the parish that I live in, you know, there's no laws against dogs being more or less free range and running off of your property and such. So, there's no laws against that. I don't understand the reasoning behind it. It's stupid. And if they wanted to break into the fence, well, cutting the fence was a stupid idea, and the only other reason I can think of is so they can purposely, you know, like, something. You know, some stupid reason with the dogs. Like, somebody stupidly cut the fence, put it simply, with no good reason beyond to piss me off. And there goes a police officer. But if y'all got any suggestions on what I should do, and don't ask to call the police, because they're not going to do anything. They're not going to investigate it, and if they do investigate it, what they're going to do? Slap the person on the wrist? And even then, you know, at the end of the day, even if it is the person I suspect it to be, I have no proof beyond, you know, the simple factor that they just don't like me. you know, which is not proof and such. So I honestly don't know what I'm going to do. And there isn't really any point in fixing or repairing a fence if the same bastard or idiot going to go and cut the fence again. So what am I supposed to do? If y'all got any suggestions, I would like to hear it, because if I don't get any suggestions, I'm going to make it into a nuclear situation. Because, you know, once I meet the person face to face, and I, like I said, I know who it might be. It could be the owner of the darn trailer park. You know, because he really doesn't like my ass. You know. And he doesn't like the dogs either. Yeah. And he's the only person that I can think of that would do something like that. Or have something like that done. Anyhow. And once I find him, once I see him, you know, if I don't have anything to basically distract me from the idea of beating his ass or taking a machete to his vehicle, then if there's nothing to prevent me, mentally speaking, from doing that, I will do it. And then I probably won't be able to make any more YouTube videos because of it, because I don't take shit like that lying down. And I need a legal way of handling it. Yeah. But if there isn't any, then there's only one other option. That's the illegal way. And I don't want to do the illegal way. So, yeah.